Viewers, here R.P. Srivastava with a new topic in economics, new welfare economics, and the subtopic of today's discussion is Parisian optimum. Before going to analyze all about Parisian economics, let us have a brief overview about my earlier discussion, that is of Pigouvian welfare economics. As we know that the term welfare has been defined and approached in a number of ways, as economic welfare, social welfare, and others. PIGU has its own measurement of welfare, where he say that economic welfare is that part of general welfare which can be brought directly or indirectly into relation with the measuring rod of money, where the emphasis on Pigou's discussion was to measure the welfare in terms of money. Mainly three studies are there that is about welfare economics. The first given by Pigou, who was the pioneer in welfare economics. Second, that is called new welfare economics, and the credit goes mainly to Wilfredo Pareto. And lastly, the shortcoming of Paretean welfare economics was taken care of by Arrow through his social welfare function. So, now discuss Paretean optimum in detail. What is the objective of Pareto's study of welfare economics? As according to Professor K. E. Boulding, the Paretean welfare economics also seems to have had three main objectives. So, according to Professor Boulding, three objectives are there on the basis of which Pareto has studied welfare economics. First, to clarify and quantify the vague concept of riches, or in the language of Professor Adam Smith, that is opulence. So, what is the concept of opulence? To define is the main objective of Paretean discussion. The second, to clarify what is the economist have to say on matter of public policy. So, that is to try to set up standards of judgment by which events and policies can be judged as economically desirable, even though on the other grounds they may just to be undesirable. So the second objective here, to clarify that how far the public policy in discussion is economically suitable or a standard one. However, it may be not as it is on the parameter that is discussed under the domain of political analysis, national or ethical analysis. And the third objective, that is to develop propositions which are scientifically free from ethical judgment. So these are the three propositions or objectives on the basis of which Professor Wilfred Pareto forwarded his study or discuss about his optimum analysis, that is also known as Paretean optimum. Before coming to the discussion about Paretean optimum, Pareto has taken some assumptions about his further study, that is about Paretean optimum analysis. So let us discuss here what are the assumptions on the basis of which he carry forward his study about Paretian optimum, or what are the assumptions lying behind his Paretian optimum. So the first assumption, that is ordinal measurement of utility. Here it is a contrast with Pigouvian welfare economics. Pigou moved forward on the basis of cardinal measurement of utility, while Pareto thinks that ordinal measurement of utility is there. Second, non-admissibility of interpersonal comparison of utility. So Pareto thinks that interpersonal comparison of utility is not possible. Third, uses the technique of indifference curve analysis for derivation of theoretical proposition, just like in consumer behavior, where there is the provision of ordinal analysis of the measurement of utility. We discuss indifference curve approach, and same is the proposition here. In context of discussing the theoretical criteria of Paretian optimum, he uses the indifference curve approach. The fourth assumption, that is fine divisibility of goods and factors and easy mobility of factors of production. And the fifth, that is given state of technology and production, substitutability of factor. So the last assumption of Paretian optimum, that is the state of technology is there, that is given production conditions are there, and there may be the possibility that one factor may be substituted for another. Having these five important assumptions, Pareto discussed his conditions of Paretian optimum. Let us first discuss what is Pareto optimality. Pareto was the first economist to formulate a positive criteria for increase or decrease in social welfare, and thereby to define a position of maximum welfare for society. In doing that, he considered the distribution of income as given and based his criteria on the optimum organization of production and exchange. Formulate positive criteria to define a position of maximum welfare for society. And second point here, that distribution of income given and optimum organization of production, including exchange, is there. Any change, the basic point here, that any change that makes at least one individual better off and no one worse off is an improvement in social welfare. Conversely, we can say that a change that makes no one better off and at least one worse off is a decrease in social welfare. So Pareto optimality may be defined as a situation in which it is impossible to make anyone better off without making someone worse off. That is said to be Pareto optimal or Pareto efficient, when any change in production or exchange is not in position to increase the total social welfare or any individual social welfare without decreasing another one. So Pareetian optimum is defined in various ways, but the main point here is that the situation will be optimum where no possibility existing to increase in social welfare. So now discuss that what are the marginal conditions for Pareto optimality, or what are the marginal conditions of Pareto optimality. For the attainment of a Pareto efficient situation in any economy, three marginal conditions must be satisfied according to Pareto. The first, that is efficiency of distribution of commodities among consumers, that is also called efficiency in exchange. It requires that marginal rate of substitution between two goods be equal for all consumers. Here, if we take two goods under consideration, so marginal rate of substitution between two goods must be equal for all the consumers existing there. So symbolically, we say that MR, marginal rate of satisfaction of consumer A for the commodity X and Y, must be equal to marginal rate of substitution for consumer B in terms of the goods X and Y. This is the first condition of Pareetian optimality. The second condition, that is efficiency of allocation of factors among firms, that is efficiency of production. It requires that the marginal rate of technical substitution between any pairs of input for all commodities produced by different firms. So here, if two factors are there produced by different producer, then the marginal rate of technical substitution in case of producer X in terms of factors labor and capital, here L and K, must be equal to marginal rate of technical substitution for producer Y in terms of the factors here labor and capital, that is L and K. So here must be the equality of marginal rate of technical substitution between different factors in use for different different producers. And the third point of marginal condition of Pareto optimality is defined as efficiency in the allocation of factors among commodities, that is efficiency in the product mix or composition of output. It requires that the marginal rate of product transformation between any two commodities be equal to the marginal rate of substitution between the same two goods. And symbolically, marginal rate of product transformation in terms of commodity X and Y is equal to marginal rate of substitution for consumer A for the goods X and Y must be equal to marginal rate of substitution for consumer B in terms of good X and Y. So these are the three marginal conditions of Pareto optimality. Here it is worth mentionable that Professor Pareto used the Edgeworth box of exchange criteria, and through this his device Edgeworth contract curve of exchange, एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट ही रिस्ट एज एट द पॉइंट ऑफ लेवल ऑफ परेटो ऑप्टिमलिटी. नाउ ए सिचुएशन मे बी परेटो ऑप्टिमल विदाउट मैक्सिमाइजेशन ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर. सो देयर मे बी द कंडीशन ऑफ परेटो ऑप्टिमलिटी बट मे नॉट बी देयर द मैक्सिमाइजेशन ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर. हेयर द परेटियन ऑप्टिमलिटी लैक्स. हैविंग ऑल दिस डिस्कशंस अबाउट परेटियन ऑप्टिमम कंडीशन हेयर वी कैन कंक्लूड दैट द मार्जिनल कंडीशन ऑफ एक्सचेंज एंड प्रोडक्शन आर द नेसेसरी और फर्स्ट ऑर्डर कंडीशन फॉर अटेनिंग परेटो ऑप्टिमिलिटी. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर कंडीशन बट दे आर नॉट सफिशियंट टू इंश्योर दैट मैक्सिमाइजेशन ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर विल बी देयर. ऑल पॉइंट्स ऑन द प्रोडक्शन पॉसिबिलिटी कर्व दैट इज पीपीसी आर परेटो ऑप्टिमल. ऑफकोर्स ऑल द पॉइंट्स ऑन द पीपीसी आर द पॉइंट ऑफ परेटियन ऑप्टिमम बट द चॉइस अमोंग दीज अल्टरनेटिव्स ऑल दिस पॉइंट ऑन द पीपीसी रिक्वायर्स सम मेजर्स ऑफ क्राइटेरिया ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर फंक्शन. सो द टास्क ऑफ मेजरिंग द सोशल वेलफेयर और डिस्कशन ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर फंक्शंस डिजायर्स हेयर टू फुलफिल द सेकेंड ऑर्डर कंडीशन ऑफ परेटो ऑप्टिमलिटी वेयर द सिचुएशन ऑफ मैक्सिमाइजेशन ऑफ सोशल वेलफेयर विल बी पॉसिबल. सो we will discuss the social welfare functions to complete the lacking of Pareto optimality in my next class. Thank you.